Welcome to Padmavati Junior College Online Classes. My name is E.M. Naidu, Principal of Padmavati Junior College. Today, discuss about the topic Complex Numbers, Maths, Mathematics 2A, Exercise 1C, Some Problems. Number 1, if Z equal to Z1 equal to minus 1, and Z2 equal to minus I, then find R Z1 Z2. So first of all we find R Z1 and R Z. Z1 equal to minus 1. Now it is the convert the problem for cos pi plus I sin pi. Cos pi equal to minus 1, sin pi equal to 0. So minus 1 plus I into 0, that equal to minus 1. So that implies R Z1 equal to the angle pi, that is the R Z1. Z2 equal to minus I cos minus pi by 2 plus I sin minus pi by 2. So cos 90 0, sin 90 1, minus sin minus 90 equal to minus sin 90, so that equal to minus I. So minus I, it is a convert to the follow form cos minus pi by 2 plus I sin minus pi by 2, that implies R Z2 equal to minus pi by 2. Now R Z1 Z2 equal to R Z1 plus R Z2, that is the formula. So multiply into the formula plus vastundi, so that equal to R Z1 equal to pi, R Z2 equal to minus pi by 2. So that is the answer, pi minus pi by 2, pi by 2, that is the R Z1 Z2. Now second one, if Z1 equal to minus 1 and Z2 equal to I, then find R Z1 by Z2. In similar way, Z1 equal to minus 1, it is cos pi plus I sin pi. Z, that implies R Z1 equal to pi. Z2 equal to I, so it is 0 plus I into 1, that equal to cos pi by 2 plus I sin pi by 2, cos 90 0 plus sin 90 1. So that implies R Z2 equal to pi by 2, the angle is pi by 2. So that implies now Arg Z1 by Z2, the formula is Arg Z1 minus Arg Z2. So multiply into plus vastundi, divided by into minus vastundi. So Arg Z1 is pi, Arg Z2 is minus pi by 2, minus pi by 2, so that equal to pi by 2. Now next problem, third one, if root 3 plus I equal to R into cos theta plus I sin theta, then find the value of theta in radian measure, then find the value of theta. Theta. Solution. 2 3 plus I equal to R into cos theta plus I sin theta. So comparing the real part, root 3 plus I equal to R cos theta plus I into R sin theta. So that implies R cos theta equal to root 3 real part comparison. Imaginary part is R sin theta equal to 1 implies cos theta equal to root 3 play by R and sin theta equal to 1 by R, where R equal to square root of x square plus y square. Now what is the x value? Root 3. So root 3 whole square plus 1 square, the square root, that is root 4, that equal to 2. That implies cos theta equal to root 3 by 2 and sin theta equal to 1 by 2. So what is the value of cos theta? Cos theta equal to 3 by 2. That implies theta equal to 30 degrees. Cos 30 degrees. So that is the radian. That is the solution. Therefore, the 5 by 6 is satisfied these two equations. Hence, the theta value is, therefore, the theta value is 5 by 6 is satisfying the above equations. Hence, theta equal 5 by 6. Now, third problem. Fourth one, if root 3 plus I whole 400 equal to 499 A plus I B, then so that A square plus B square equal to 4. It's a very simple problem. Solution. Root 3 plus I whole 400 equal to 2499 into A plus IB. In similar way, this is the first equation. Root 3 minus I whole 400 equal to 2499 into A minus IB. It is the equation number 2. Now, these two equations are multiplying equation 1 multiplying equation 2. That implies root 3 plus I whole power 100, root 3 minus I whole power 100, that is equal to 2 power 99 A plus I B into 2 power 99 A minus IB, that equal root 3 square 3 minus I square whole power 100 2 power 99 1 198 A square minus I square B square, A plus IB into A minus IB, that equal to A square minus I square B square. That implies 3 plus 1 whole power 100, 2 power 198, A square plus B square. Since I square equal to minus 1, that implies 4 power 100, 2 power 199, A square plus B square. So, what is 4 equal to 2 square? 2 square whole power 100, that equal to 2 power 199, A square plus B square, that implies 2 power 200, that equal to 2 power 190, 198, a square to b square. That implies a square to b square equal to 2 power 200 by 2 power 198 that equal to 2 square that equal to 4. Therefore, a square to b square equal to 4. Now, next problem. If z equal to x plus psi y and mod z equal to 1, then find the locus of z. Then find the locus of z. Okay, solution. Z equal to x plus psi y implies mod z equal to square root of x square plus y square. Given that mod z equal to 1, that implies square root of x square plus y square equal to 1. Squaring on both sides, that implies x square plus y square equal to 1 square. That implies x square plus y square equal to 1. That is the locus of z. Therefore, the locus of z is x square plus y square minus 1 equal to 0. Now the next problem. This one. If the amplitude of z minus 1 is pi by 2, find the locus of z. Find the locus of z. Okay, solution. Z minus 1, z equal to x plus psi y. So z minus 1 equal to x plus I y minus 1, that is x minus 1 plus I y. It is the real part x minus y and imaginary part y. So it is given that the amplitude of z minus 1 is tan inverse imaginary part by real part. That is the formula. Imaginary part by real part. That equal to pi by 2. It is given that the amplitude of z minus 1 is pi by 2. So that implies y minus x minus 1. Y by x minus 1 equal to tan pi by 2. Tan 90 is infinity. That implies so y minus x minus 1 is infinity. So the denominator is 0. That implies x minus 1 is 0. Therefore, the solution, the locus of z is x minus 1 equal to 0. Now the next problem. If z equal to 1 plus 2i by 1 minus I whole square, then find arc z. Then find arc z. So listen, z equal to 1 plus 2i by 1 minus I whole square. Now we simplify the complex number a in the form of 1 plus a plus ib. 1 plus 2i, 1 minus 1 square, 1 plus I square minus 2i. So that equals 1 plus 2i by 1 minus 1 minus 2i. So these two cancel. Since I square equal to minus 1, that equals 1 plus 2i by 1 plus 2i. So that equal to these two cancel, that equal to 1. So that is 1 plus I into 0. It is the form of A plus IB. Now arg z equal to form tan inverse y by x. Okay. And z equal to x plus y by implies rz. So therefore rz equal to tan inverse. The imaginary part y equal to 0. So 0 by 1 are equal to tan inverse 0. Tan 0 equal to 0. The rz is 0 and 1. Now this problem. If mod z minus 3 plus I equal to 4, determine the locus of z. Determine the locus of z. It's a very simple problem. Solution. Mod z minus 3 plus I equal to 4. That z equal to x plus y implies mod x plus y minus 3 plus I equal to 4. That implies modulus. Now the surface in the real and imaginary part. X minus 3 is a real part. Now imaginary part is y plus 1. That equal to 4. So modulus means square root of real part square. X minus 3 square, imaginary part square, y plus 1 whole square, that equal to 4. Now, squaring on both sides, squaring on both sides, that implies, so square it is cancel, x minus 3 whole square plus y plus 1 whole square, that equal to 4 square, 16. Okay, that implies x square minus 6x plus 9 y squared plus 2y plus 1 minus 16 equal to 0. That implies x squared plus y squared minus 6x plus 2y 10 minus 6 and minus 6 equal 0. That is the locus of z. Therefore, the locus of z is x squared plus y squared minus 6x plus 2y minus 6 equal to 0. Okay, next problem. If mod z plus a I equal to mod z minus a I, then find the locus of z. In similar way, solution. Let z equal to x plus I y. It is given that mod z plus a I equal to mod z minus a I. That implies mod z x plus I y plus a I mod x plus I y minus a I. Because x, z equal to x plus I y. That implies now suppressing the real and imaginary part. Real part is x, I into y plus a is the imaginary part. Since similar, x plus I into y minus a, it is imaginary part. Now, modulus means square root of real part square and x square, y plus a whole square, imaginary part square. In similar way, square root of x square, y minus a whole square. Now, on both sides, squaring on both sides implies x square y square plus 2y 2ay plus a square equal to x square plus y square minus 2ay plus a square. Now x square is cancelled, y square is cancelled and a square is cancelled. 2ay 4ay equal to 0. 4a is constant. So y equal to 0. Therefore, the locus of z is y equal to 0. Now the 10th problem.